In the previous video, we looked at JavaScript objects, properties, and methods. In this video, we're going to be looking at a very useful method called the getElementById method. And it's a method that returns the element on in a document that has an ID of a specified value. So when we call the getElementById method, we specify an ID of an element that we want to access. And then this method can be used to manipulate or get information from that element in the document. So for example, if we want to modify the contents of, say, a paragraph or a heading, we wanted to change the text content, then we could use this method. If we wanted to change the style or appearance of an element on a page, such as changing the color of text or changing an image on a page, then we could use this method. So the way it works is an element on the page that we want to either manipulate or get information from, we give it an ID, and an ID should be unique and only used once on the web page. So we give that element an ID, and then we use the getElementById method to find that element on the page that has that specific ID that we've specified, and then we can go and either get the information from that element, find out what its current contents is. So for example, if it's a paragraph, find out what text content is in the paragraph, or we could change the content or the appearance, style, and so on. So we're going to look at how to use that in this video. And as an example, what we'll do is we have a paragraph here. It just says, click me. So we're using the paragraph or P element in our HTML code, and we'll give this paragraph a specific ID, and then we're going to use in our JavaScript code over here on the right, we're going to add a function that will be called when we click the text, and it will then change the contents of the paragraph or maybe change the style as well. So firstly, to use the getElementById method, whatever element we want to call this method on, it needs to have an ID that's unique. So I'm going to add an ID here. Just call this paragraph element my text. All right, and then what we'll also do is add an onClick event here, which will call a function, which I'll add to the JavaScript code in a minute. We'll call this function changeText. So basically, when this this paragraph is clicked by the user, it's going to call a function called changeText. All right, so if we go back to the page after saving the code and just refresh the page, we can see the text is there. Okay, so that's all we need to do in our HTML code. We just need to give the element that we want to access an ID that's unique. All right, and we can access that element through either maybe when the page loads or some other form, some other event, but in this case, we're going to be accessing this element by its ID with an onClick event, which calls this function. Okay, so over in the JavaScript code now, let's create that function. So we'll say function change text. All right, and in this function, we're now going to get this element, this paragraph element, by referring or specifying this ID here. All right, and we'll store it in a variable. So we'll create a variable called my text equals, and then we're going to call the getElementById method on the document. So we say document.getElementById, and then in parentheses and quotation marks, we're going to specify the ID of the element we want to get. And that ID is just here, it's my text. So we're going to specify that ID, and then just a semicolon to end that line. So there we go, that's the getElementById method being used in this document here to grab this particular element here, the paragraph element that has this specific ID. All right, I've already got that script linked here in the web page. All right, so when this function is called, it gets that element, stores it in the variable. Now what we can do if we want to change the contents of this paragraph is we can modify its inner HTML. So the inner HTML is basically what goes between these two angle brackets, or the greater than and less than signs. Okay, so the actual contents of this element, the actual contents of the paragraph, the text, that's what we're going to modify, and that's called the inner HTML of the element, the actual content. So we're going to refer to this variable that we've already created, say my text dot inner HTML. And we don't necessarily need to create a variable. What we could do is just do this in one line. We could say document.getElementById my text and then dot inner HTML equals. But what we've done is just put this into a variable, so now we can refer to this variable however many times we want, rather than always having to repeat document.getElementById, etc. So say my text.inner HTML equals, and then in quotation marks, we can specify the new content or inner HTML. So we can say you clicked here. Okay, so save all of that. We can go back to the page again and refresh it. Now, if I click on this text, we can see that the content's changed. If we refresh the page again, it said click me. When I click on the text, it says you clicked here. Okay, so we've changed the inner HTML of that paragraph. We've changed its contents. Now, if we wanted to see what the existing content was, what text was already there before we changed it, what we could do is go back a line and we can just log to the console, console.log, my text.inner HTML. So before we modify the inner HTML, we can just see what it already is and just log that to the console. But we could, you know, if we wanted to grab the contents from the paragraph and store it in a variable and use it in other ways, then, you know, we could do that as well. But we're just going to log it to the console. All right, so refresh the page. I've already saved all the code. Refresh the page, click the text, and we can see here it's logged click me. All right, so that was what was the inner HTML. So it's logged out to the console before then changing the inner HTML to you clicked here. All right, now when I click on that text again, we can see that it logs you clicked here instead, because that's the new inner HTML that's been replaced. All right. Okay, there's more we can do. So other than just modifying the contents or inner HTML of an element, we can also modify the style. So we could say my text dot, and actually when we type in this variable, type in dot in Visual Studio Code, you'll see there's a number of different methods and properties that come up that we can use. Okay, so lots of different things we can do. But in this case, we're going to change the style. So my text.style dot, and then there's lots of different things we can change for the style. So we can change background color, the text color, we could change the size, padding, margins, opacity, all sorts of different things that we could normally do in CSS code, but we can also do here in JavaScript code. So we can say my text.style dot maybe color for this example equals, and then we can specify a new value for the color style, for example green. Okay, if we refresh the page and scroll up, now if we click the text, not only does it change the contents of the text, the paragraph, but it also changes the color there as well. Now what we can also do is, other than getting the inner HTML, sometimes we might want to get the value of something, for example, a text box. So what I'm going to do here is add a text box, and I'm going to, so I'm going to say input type equals, text. All right, which adds a text box there. Right, and we won't add any buttons or anything like that, but we'll just add the text box there. Okay, I'm going to give this an ID. call it my text box. All right, what we're going to do is when we click on the text here, we're going to grab the value that's typed, whatever the user's typed into the text box, and we'll just display it in the console over here. So I'm going to add a couple more lines here. I'm going to say, I'm going to do this all in one go. We'll create a new variable. So my text box equals document dot get element by ID, my text box. And then we're going to say console.log my text box dot value. So this time, instead of getting the inner HTML, we're getting the value, and that's going to be whatever's typed into the text box. Okay, so if we're working with an input, for example, something like a text box, we are going to be using value instead of inner HTML. All right, let's go back, refresh the page. I'm just going to type some random text in there, click the text, and now we can see it's also logged the contents of that text box there. And if I change that contents, click again, we can see it's gotten the new value there from the text box. Okay, so here we've used .innerHTML to modify the contents of an element on a page. We've used .style to modify the style or appearance of an element on a page. And here we've used .value to grab the value from an input, in this case, a text box. All right, so those are just some examples of what we can do once we've used the get element by ID method on a web page. So it's a very useful method, and you'll use it a lot in JavaScript when you want to get information from the page or modify elements or manipulate elements on a page. One last thing to mention is that if we were to have multiple elements using the same ID, what would happen is the method would just return the first element that has that ID. So IDs should always be unique and used just once on a page. For example, if I copy and paste this paragraph a few times and they all have the same, all of these paragraphs have the same ID, what will happen is when I call this method here on the getElementById method on paragraphs that have that ID, it's only going to return the first one. So if we refresh this page, if I click any of these, because all of them have an onClick event that calls that change text function, if I click any of them, we'll see that only the first element with that ID is returned and modified. Okay, so that's it for this video. We'll be looking at some other similar methods in the next few videos, and we'll be looking at more things that we can do once we're now working with this get element by ID method. That's it for this video. Thanks for watching.